The conversation on the left revolves almost exclusively around identity, which is, in other words, me. Narcissism is about me.
Yeah.
But you kept talking about economics. That used to be the central conversation on the left, or in America, actually.
Yeah.
Why no more?
Because the establishment has learned how to co-opt identity politics to put the brakes on economic progress and justice. So the joke I do, so if you want to help, I would say if you want to help black people, nothing would help them more than free college, student loan relief, and Medicare for all, and a living wage. You want to help them, that would be the way to help them. But Joe Biden comes in, does none of those things, but he makes Juneteenth a holiday. So do you understand what I'm talking about?
Oh, I do understand.
So it's all signals, but there's no substance. We're signaling that we want to help the minority community, but we're not actually helping them. So that's what identity politics is. It's a big diversion. And the joke I say, you know, if it was 1860, the Democrats would be bragging about their first transgendered slave owner. And so what I'm trying to tell people is that when you vote for them, when you vote for somebody inside the Democratic Party, no matter what they say, no matter what they believe, they're going to go along with Nancy Pelosi. And Nancy Pelosi goes along with Goldman Sachs and Raytheon. So when you're voting for someone inside the Democratic Party, you're voting for Goldman Sachs and Raytheon because they are not standing up to those people. So the idea that we have progressives inside the Democratic Party, it's actually more deleterious to the progressive movement to have them there. Why is that, Jimmy? Because it gives people a false impression that there's somebody in government fighting for you, that there's one of the parties that are kind of on your side, and they aren't. And the quicker people realize that both parties are not on their side, they only serve the oligarchy. We are in fact in an oligarchy. Your democracy was stolen way before Trump. Until that happens, we won't ever have real change.